45% of all plant species in the world are threatened with extinction.
We need to help mend those systems and get some of these species back out again.
There's all kinds of properties that these plants possess that we don't even begin to understand.
Restoration is needed more than ever in the whole history of humankind.
It's absolutely key to our survival on the planet.
The Millennium Seed Bank is really a giant store of life, where we've collected and conserved seeds from plants around the world.
Behind me are the vaults, kept at minus 20 degrees.
They're floodproof, bombproof, radiation-proof, and they're highly secure.
We have more than 40,000 different species here.
So you have that amazing insurance policy, really, for those plants which have been conserved to date. But in addition, we have an awful lot of research that goes on here.
Cryopreservation, restoration, germination,
quality of the seed,
medicines for the future,
conservation,
food security,
resilience to extreme heat,
crop diversity.
We haven't even begun to understand the complexity of plants.
And that's why it's important that we conserve them.
I just can't help feeling that there are amazing discoveries that are going to revolutionise the way we live, thanks to us saving these little individual species in one place.
So at the moment, there are various challenges facing biodiversity around the globe. Global food security is a huge issue. We're reliant on a very few species of crops for all of our nutritional intake. I think some 90% comes from only 15 crops. So they're very vulnerable to the impacts of climate change. There's some 70,000, and I think even more, wild plants that are known to be edible, but they're not classified as foodstuffs. We focus only on some, I think, 300 that are classified as foodstuffs. So we really need to just grow this area and our understanding of what we can eat. Diversify not only the sources of our food, but also how we grow them. Seed banking is just hugely important. We go out and collect these seeds from the wild populations.
I've seen some of the things that collectors do. Getting to those remote places to find the rarest plants is a really thrilling and chilling adventure.
No human ever collected plants here.
We've had seed collectors go out on trips and they've arrived and they've been too late. That plant didn't exist there anymore. So we have a pressing need to get there now.
It's very tempting to think that by putting something in cold storage, it means you can shut the door and just let seeds sleep gently. Unfortunately, that is not necessarily the case.
The first step is drying. So the seeds will be dried in our dry room. Once the seeds are dried, they're cleaned. And then the seeds are also checked for quality. So they'll be x-rayed to check that the seeds are full and not damaged. Once they've gone through that whole process, they'll be banked at minus 20 degrees Celsius in our seed vault. Seeds can live for, in some cases, hundreds or even possibly thousands of years.
There are limitations to seed bankings. You can't store every species of plant in a seed bank.
We need to find other solutions for them.
There are some species which can't tolerate drying, so we use cryopreservation techniques. What we do is we move what we call the embryo, and because that's much smaller, we can then dry it very quickly, and then that can then be cryopreserved. This is our cryopreservation facility. So in here currently we've got three vessels which are filled with liquid nitrogen. They're stored in the vapor phase. So So the temperature there is around minus 170 degrees Celsius. So it's very cold inside. That's why I've got these blue gloves on. But even then, I can still feel the cold coming through and the gloves are starting to freeze. Currently, we have probably around 5,000 samples in these vessels.
So we started off as very much, let's conserve as much as we can. But if we want to save plants from extinction, we won't do that by keeping them in a cold room. Ultimately, the destination of all of the materials that come here is to find a pathway for them to be returned to the wild.
Seeds are really important in restoration because they are basically plants that have been flat packed and so reduced down to sort of tiny little lightweight packages. They've got all the essential ingredients. So when you have a natural disturbance in nature, all the surrounding trees will disperse their seeds into the area and it can regenerate. But when you have massive landscape scale degradation caused by humans, there just aren't enough seeds in the landscape to do this. So sometimes nature needs a helping hand and we need to introduce plant materials into the landscape to do this. The most successful restoration project that I've ever seen is our partners in northern Thailand. There were forests there that used to be barren hillsides of maize and cabbages, and now you wouldn't know that they're not natural forests. What we're doing is helping them to find ways to scale up seed supply. And one of the big questions is, will these plants that we're planting today be able to survive climate change? A freezer full of seeds, they might be alive, but that's not a forest. That's not a meadow. So by taking them out, planting them in the landscapes and just seeing them flourish into an actual habitat, and then you see wildlife moving in, then you see more species coming in, I think it's one of the most satisfying things you can do.
And that's why it's important that we conserve them so that we have that potential for the future by the time that our understanding increases. We're buying time, really. That's what a seed bank does.
I think what our biggest challenge is going to be is, in a way, when we're bringing seeds into the bank, it's like we're taking apart the pieces of a natural ecosystem. It's like there's a wonderful puzzle and we're taking it apart. We put it in a cold storage. And then when we take them out again, it's, oh, where are the corners? We need to work out how those pieces can be put back into a beautiful new wild landscape where they will thrive.